What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Seth Paulo, and I want you to look at the background of these photos, especially on the roof. You can see we have so many blue pattern on the roof, the board on the sides, and also the curtain box, and I just hated it. I could not even take a successful selfie, a pic, without having so much blue on my background, which I did not like. That I wanted to just have one color in my house, the roof and the wall. So I painted my house white and the roof. As you saw in my house tour video, it was not this color, it was greenish crimson yellow, and I painted this place white, but then I lost the video of where I did that, and so that's why I am showing you this video here, where you can see I've already painted one coat on the roof, but my paint ran out, and so I had to get extra paint after like a month, and then I came to finish this project. And I just want to show you guys how it looks now. You can see the roof is white, but it's not that white. So I came in with another coat here of paint, and I just painted very carefully because I had to make sure that the paint does not drop down. And guys, by the way, if you have not subscribed to this channel, kindly do that. Subscribe, turn on the notification bell, and get to see what I have to offer, and also share with your friends who have tiny spaces and they want to transform them so that they can be inspired. And so, guys, as you can see, I am painting my roof, and it is the hardest task to do. Oh my God. Painting the roof was harder than painting the whole house. And I mean the sitting room, the bedroom, the kitchen, and the toilet. It was easier painting those than painting only these patterns on the roof. One thing, because you cannot go very fast because you're painting a very tiny part, which is that square that you're seeing me paint here. And the paint drops a lot, like it falls on your hair, it falls on everything. So you have to make sure that you wear a shower cap as you paint, you wear gloves, because the paint is going to cause quite a mess. And then use a small amount of paint too. As you can see on these tiny parts, which kind of look matte, you can see that I have painted them, and they're different from these ones here. So these ones still has the blue on them, and these ones are now white. Now that is what I want to achieve. Change these, the whole of it, and make it white. And I took about 4 to 5 coats of paint, guys. So I used about 1.5 liters. Yes, I used 1.5 because I made a mistake and bought a very bad quality paint, which is Orion. And guys, never buy that paint because it literally wasted me. I'll show you. I ended up using it somewhere else, but here I now used a water paint, a water-based paint, which was Basco paint, and it turned out well, just as crown. Now this is the bathroom, guys. I decided that the Orion paint, I was not going to waste it on the roof because I was getting tired. And so I came to paint the bathroom, and as you can see, guys, this is how it looks. This is a coat of paint. It looks this terrible, and the paint was so light, it was not thick at all, and you cannot even dilute it, because if you dilute it, then it becomes very light like water. It also smells nasty, guys. Oh my God, the paint smells like urine that has rotten urine. That is how that Orion paint smells like, and I would not recommend it at all. It was a waste of money. I painted the whole 0.5 liter, and as you can see, it looks like I have literally painted with chalk. Like I just diluted chalk in water and I painted. This is 0.5 liter of Orion paint, and it is bad. And I decided that, you know what, it's very light, so let me just use this paint without diluting it. And as you can see, our landlord is also a very big miser, because this is apparently not red paint, it is cement. He used cement to paint the bathroom, and that is why also painting was a very bad task. And for this coat, it is the Orion now that I used undiluted, and still not a very good result, as you can see, because this is undiluted paint and it looks like this. So I eventually decided to use now the Basco paint that I bought, and as you can see, it applies totally different. It applies a thicker layer, a better layer, and it's also easier to apply. It does not cause as much wastage and that as the Orion paint. So I just advise you, if you're going to paint, just go for a good quality paint, which for me, the ones that I would recommend is Basco paint, Crown paint, what else? And Duracoat. Those are the ones I would recommend from Kenya. The other ones, kina Orion na Solai, tafadhali, just add that 150 or 200 and just get a good quality paint. It's going to save you money, a lot of money, and also going to save you time. So as you can see, this is how now my bathroom is turning out, but I have not yet finished the transformation, guys. So if you want to see how I will completely turn this bathroom, because I ran out of paint again, make sure you keep watching, because within the course of this week and next week, I'm going to post my house tour where I'll show you everything, and I hope I'll see you then, guys. Bye bye. Go watch this video to see how it looked like before transformation.